بسم الله الرحمن الرحیم. السلام علیکم و رحمت الله و برکاته. May peace, blessings and mercy of Allah, God Almighty be upon all of you. Welcome to 99 Names and Attributes of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Today inshallah, we briefly explain name number 61, Al-Wahid. Al-Wahid means the unique, the one without a partner. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one because He is the only one to be worshipped, the only one having no beginning and no end, the only one who is eternal and shall remain forever, the only one who is all-powerful, all-knowing, ever-present, and nothing is hidden from Him, the only one who is born to none and none is born to Him, and He has no partner or sharer. Allah is one because He is one in His actions and in His names. He has no partner or equal in His attributes. Your God is one God. There is no God but Him, the All-Merciful, the Most Merciful. Surah Al-Baqarah, number 2, ayah number 163. For centuries, people who have failed to grasp Allah's greatness have worshipped what they consider to be superior and powerful beings, such as the sun or stars. Furthermore, despite all their feebleness, some people even dared to declare themselves as deities. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the example of a man who argued with Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam about Allah's unity and power. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam responded in the following terms. What about the one who argued with Ibrahim about his Lord on the basis that Allah had given him sovereignty? Ibrahim said, "My Lord gives life and causes to die." He said, "I too give life and cause to die." Ibrahim said, "Allah makes the sun come from the east, make it come from the west." And the one who was the unbeliever was dumbfounded. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not guide wrongdoing people. Surah Al-Baqarah, number 2, ayah number 258. Setting up any other deity with Allah is not unique to previous people, for we see it even in our own time. While modern people do not worship the sun, particular stars, or similar items, they worship people who are just as helpless as themselves with such concepts as beauty, wealth, and power. They devote their lives to acquiring wealth and never once wonder if Allah is pleased with them. They consider people, other beings, or particular objects as equal to Allah and so clearly associate partners with Him. Given that Allah is the Creator, no one can make the sun rise from the west, stop the universe from expanding, hold the heavens and earth, or create a human being from nothing. Allah is the only God, for nothing that exists can be equal to the Creator. The Quran describes the weakness of those who associate partners with Allah as follows. O mankind, an example has been made, so listen carefully. Those whom you call upon besides Allah cannot create a single fly, even if they were to join together to do it. And if a fly steals something from them, they cannot get it back. How feeble are both the seeker and the sought. Surah Al-Hajj, number 22, ayah number 73. Or have they assigned partners to Allah who create as He creates, so that all creating seems the same to them? Say, Allah is the Creator of everything. He is the One, the All-Conquering. Surah Ar-Ra'd, number 13, ayah number 16. The Messiah, Isa, son of Maryam, was only the messenger of Allah and His word, which He cast into Maryam and a spirit from him. So believe in Allah and His messengers. Do not say three. It is better that you stop. Allah is only one God. He is too glorious to have a son. Everything in the heavens and in earth belongs to Him. Allah suffices as a guardian. Surah An-Nisa, number 4, ayah number 171. Until next time, peace السلام علیکم و رحمت الله و برکاته.